What would you say if a client asked you how long it would take to implement a custom application for their small business, a corner shop selling some essentials for a busy downtown neighborhood? Well, before answering this, you should probably learn more about the requirements and run some data structure drafts by the client. So here it goes. First of all, there has to be a list of products that the client sells. In addition to the product name, there should also be brand info, stored in some separate list, of course. Besides essential, the client also provides some services, like carpet cleaning and key cutting. So he needs a way of telling his goods from his services. There will be hundreds of items in the client's product list. So he wants them organized in a tree-like structure with folders, subfolders, and so on, without limiting the number of levels. Now, before the client starts selling these things, he needs to decide what prices to set for each of them. I guess I could just add a price field to the table like this. But this way, when the client changes the price, the old one gets lost forever, which doesn't really work for the client. So I will need to create a separate prices table, where each product can have a history of prices changing over time, as well as a flag marking the current price, of course. Okay, now let's go to the retail part of the picture. My client doesn't produce any goods himself, so to sell anything he will need to buy it first. And, of course, every purchase transaction needs to be registered by the client, like this. Besides the date of the purchase and the total amount spent, each purchase should include a list of products bought, with each line pointing at its product and specifying the quantity and the price. As for the sales transactions, the client wants them to look basically the same, with the addition of the payment method used by a customer and the product unit price. That has to be automatically taken from the price list according to the client's requirements. Another thing that should be automated is the multiplication of the quantity by the unit price, resulting in the total price for this line. The last piece of data the client wants to have is the inventory. Information about how many products are available for sale. This table has to be automatically updated every time the client buys or sells anything. Now, let's look at this data structure one more time and try to estimate how long it might take to implement this kind of functionality. Of course, it depends on the tools and languages you will be using. And my goal today is to show you that no matter what toolset you have in mind and how quickly you think you can implement this, I will do it faster using the ONCE Enterprise platform. Let's start with the products table. I'm adding a new catalog, turning on the folders support, and adding a new product type attribute. The attribute is allowed to have one of two possible values, goods or services. So this is the type it should have. Another thing the product's catalog should have is the brand attribute, which should be another catalog so users could add new values to it. Okay, let's check how it works so far. This is our product list. Let me add a few items here real quick. Now add in some services just to check. And, there is no brand for carpet cleaning, I guess, so this field shouldn't be visible for services. And this is how it's done. I'm adding an explicit products catalog form and writing this code in the form module. Now I need to call this procedure when the form gets opened. And when the product type field value is changed. Let's see. Opening the form, selecting goods, and the brand field is here. Selecting services, and the brand field is gone. Perfect. Now let's get to the price list. I'm adding a new information register, telling it that prices can be changed as often as daily. Here goes our product reference and our price field. And this is it. Now I can open any product and start pricing it just like this. One more thing I could probably use is the latest, that is current price, right here on the main tab. So I'm going back to the same form, adding a new attribute. And writing this piece of code, like this. And here is the current Coke price. Great. Okay, before we start registering purchases and sales, let's take care of the inventory. Its purpose is to track how much of each product we have left. Let's also add a form showing this registered balance. And add it to the application interface. Now I can move on and add a purchase document with the product's nested table, having the product, quantity, and price columns in it. I would also like to see the total price of all products I'm buying, and for the document to post the product quantities to the inventory. Okay, let's see how it works. I'm creating a new purchases document, adding 5 packs of coffee and 10 bottles of Coke. Now I post this document, and here we go. These are my products in the inventory. If I add another purchases document with 20 more Cokes in it, it will be immediately reflected in the inventory balance amount. Now, to the sales document. It should have the payment method attribute with a predefined set of cash, credit, and debit values, available for a user to choose from. And it also needs the product's nested table with the product catalog reference and the quantity attribute. As for the price attribute, I want it to be calculated automatically based on the unit price attribute. Which value I will look up here in the prices register. And this is how it's done. Whenever a user selects a product, I'm calling this procedure that grabs the current row data and sets the unit price attribute value to whatever this function returns. And the setUnitPrice function looks up the last price set for the products just like that. And now I want to calculate the line total by multiplying the unit price by the quantity like this. And this procedure should be called whenever the unit price or the quantity is changed. And this is it. Now I can create new sales document, select a product, and its price automatically gets over here. Let's make sure it's the latest price set. And yes, it is. Now I'm setting a quantity and the line total is calculated automatically for me. Great. I also want to make sure that when I post a sales document, my inventory gets reduced by the amount of products sold. And here is my current code balance in the inventory. This sales document registers 3 of them sold. I'm posting it, and here is my new code balance, just like that. Okay, one last thing before we finish. This is a native Windows application. What do you think it takes to make it a web application accessible from a browser? This is what. I'm going here and clicking publish. Believe it or not, but this is it. Now I can just open a browser, type in this link, and here is my application on the internet, looking and working exactly the same. And by the way, please feel free to check out this link and play with the application yourself. How much time did we spend? This is how much. Pretty impressive, isn't it? Anything else you would like to see me implement for the next video? Leave a comment below and I will make it happen. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time.